Oh, it started now. So,
Yes, ma'am. Now
we
it's
are talking
started.
about the different functions of the blood, transportation of respiratory gas, transportation of food materials, transportation of hormones, as well as along with the food material, as well as the respiratory gas, oxygen, the function of the blood is also to carry the excretory waste. Transportation of excretory waste. pH. Maintenance of, what is the pH of blood? What is the pH of blood?
Ma'am, 7.4 plus
7.4.
minus 0.2.
7.4. So maintenance of pH of the body is also being done by the blood. Along with this, distribution of heat throughout the body is also one of the important function of blood. Distribution of heat. Distribution of heat. In order to regulate the temperature, which is being maintained by the blood, the temperature of our body is also maintained by the blood because of the distribution of the heat. It also helps in defense mechanism against infection, WBC, jo blood ka part hai. It also defense against infection. So a number of functions is being performed by the blood in our body. So it's one of the most important thing of your body. pH se leke, heat se leke, healing se leke, defense mechanism, transportation of heat, transportation of excretory waste, transportation of the respiratory gases, transportation of the food materials, transportation of the hormones. Everything is done with the help of the blood. But if you remember, in the first lecture, when we are talking about the circulatory fluid in our body, we have discussed about blood and lymph. Now we will read in brief about the lymph. Lymph is also known as tissue fluid. Someone is unmuted. So now we have to learn about the other fluid, that is lymph, which is also known as tissue fluid, which is also known as interstitial fluid, that you have to remember. Isi ka ek aur naam hai, interstitial fluid, lymph. Lymph is also a mobile connective tissue. Lymph is a mobile connective tissue. Lymph is a mobile matlab motile hai, move kar sakta hai, yahan wahan ja sakta hai. Mobile connective tissue comprises of fluid part, that is the lymph plasma. So lymph may be lymph plasma hote hain, as well as lymph corpuscles. Comprises of lymph plasma and lymph corpuscles. इसके कॉम्पोनेंट पे वही दोनों चीजें हैं जो हमारे ब्लड का होता था, लिम्फ प्लाज्मा एंड लिम्फ कॉर्पस्कल्स. नाउ वी विल रीड इन डिटेल कॉम्पोजिशन कि इज द लिम्फ प्लाज्मा एग्जैक्टली द सेम एज अ ब्लड प्लाज्मा. यस, दे आर सिमिलर विद अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ चेंज. सो फर्स्ट वी विल लर्न अबाउट द लिम्फ प्लाज्मा. lymph plasma. Okay. So we are talking about the lymph plasma. It is similar to that of the blood, but has fewer blood protein as compared to the blood plasma. जो lymph plasma होता है, similar होता है composition में to the blood plasma, but have fewer blood protein, less calcium and phosphorus, but high glucose concentration. So what are the important facts? Your lymph plasma is similar to blood plasma with less protein, with fewer plasma proteins, calcium and phosphorus, but higher glucose concentration. This is the first step. Yes, the composition is similar. We are talking about the lymph plasma composition. So composition is similar to the blood plasma with fewer plasma protein, calcium and phosphorus, but higher glucose concentration. Basically, if we look for the proteins that are present in lymph, so they are mostly globulins. They are mostly immunoglobulins. That means कि जब भी हम lymph plasma की, क्योंकि हमने यहाँ पर इसीलिए लिखा है fewer plasma proteins, because the majority of the proteins that are present in lymph are the globulin immunoglobulins. That is your antibodies. अदर कॉम्पोनेंट, जब भी हमने प्लाज्मा ब्लड प्लाज्मा के बारे में पढ़ा था, तो वहां पर बहुत सारे इनऑर्गेनिक एंड ऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस के बारे में पढ़े थे. तो अदर कॉम्पोनेंट्स ऑफ द लिम्फ प्लाज्मा आर वेरी मच लाइक दैट ऑफ द ब्लड प्लाज्मा. ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स, वेरियस इनऑर्गेनिक सब्सटेंसेस, वॉटर, वो सारा जैसा हमारे ब्लड प्लाज्मा में था वैसे ही होता है. तो डिफरेंस क्या है? फ्यूअर प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन. तो बेसिकली यहां पर जो भी प्लाज्मा प्रोटीन होता है, दे आर योर ग्लोबुलिन्स, दैट इज योर एंटीबॉडीज. अदर कॉम्पोनेंट्स, दैट मीन्स द ऑर्गेनिक इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स and water is same as blood plasma. Now we will talk about the lymph corpuscles. What are the lymph corpuscles? So yahan aapko ek cheez bahut acche se yaad rakhni hai ki when we will talk about the lymph corpuscles, to jaise hamare ब्लड में देयर आर थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉर्पस्कल्स, दैट इज योर इरिथ्रोसाइट्स, ल्यूकोसाइट्स एंड थ्रोम्बोसाइट्स. बट इन केस ऑफ लिम्फ कॉर्पस्कल्स, दे हैव ल्यूकोसाइट्स, व्हाइट ब्लड सेल्स, और उस व्हाइट ब्लड में सेल्स में भी मोस्टली दे हैव लिम्फोसाइट्स. तो दिस डिफरेंस यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर, दिस इज द इम्पोर्टेंट डिफरेंस, कि लिम्फ प्लाज्मा तो मोर और लेस सिमिलर है, बट यहाँ पर fewer proteins होते हैं, तो mostly they have globulin immunoglobulin, that is antibodies. But when we will talk about the lymph corpuscle,
ma'am,
yes बच्चा,
ma'am वो आपने arrow करके globulin लिखा है, वो मतलब protein है क्या plasma में?
Yes, fewer plasma protein, few होते हैं, but majority कौन से होते हैं? Globulins होते हैं, majority of the protein that is present in lymph plasma is your globulins. Clear? जो हमारे blood plasma में क्या होता था?
Ma'am, your voice is breaking.
My voice is breaking?
No, ma'am.
Yes.
No, ma'am.
So we are talking about the lymph corpuscles. So your lymph corpuscles are basically your leukocytes. That is your WBC. And in WBC also, most common WBC in your lymph corpuscle is your lymphocytes. Lymphocytes. Okay. Erythrocytes and platelets are absent in lymph. Mind it. लिम्फ कॉर्पस्कल्स में सिर्फ हमारा डब्ल्यूबीसी होता है, उसमें भी कौन सा डब्ल्यूबीसी होता है, दैट इज योर लिम्फोसाइट्स एंड योर आरबीसी एंड प्लेटलेट्स आर एब्सेंट. माइंड इट, आरबीसी एंड प्लेटलेट्स आर एब्सेंट. मेक अ नोट. Only WBCs are present in lymph. Okay. There are various lymphoid organs in our body. मैं actually side इसलिए हो जाती हूँ क्योंकि मैं इधर होंगी तो आप note नहीं कर सकते हो. मैं side में खड़ी होती हूँ, आप मुझे सुन सकते हो. These lymph is basically present in various lymphoid organs of our body. Ranging from your bone marrow, thymus, spleen, tonsils, pear patches, Kupffer cells, ये different cells हैं हमारे, ये different lymphoid organs हैं जहाँ lymph present होता है. तो lymphoid organs, the organ which secrete lymph are called lymphoid organs. ये जितने भी lymphoid organs का मैंने नाम लिया है, ये सारे lymphoid organs ये lymph secrete करते हैं. Besides the lymph nodes, there are various checkpoints in our body that are the lymph nodes. So lymph nodes ke alawa, thymus hai, bone marrow hai, aapka spleen hai, everywhere lymph is present consisting of a number of lymphocytes which are helpful and which are ready to help the different site of infection. Whenever there is any infection in any part of your body, these WBC will rush to that particular part or the lymph provide these WBCs in order to fight against the infection and give it to the blood. Blood ko support karta hai by providing the WBCs. So basically lymphoid organs kya hote hain? The organs which secrete lymph are called lymphoid organs. And they are your lymph nodes, tonsils, thymus, spleen, pear patches. And spleen is the largest lymphoid organ of your body. तो where should I lie? Shall I rub this side? मैंने pick नहीं किया, but you can write by yourself also.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, what you have written after
one by one, I am not getting you all. The fifth point of your function of blood is maintenance of pH of the body. So blood help to regulate the pH of the body because at different area and different organs, आपको भी पता है कि आपका stomach का acidic pH होता है. तो just like that, different blood जो है उसका खुद का basic pH होता है, that is 7.4. तो blood help करता है in the circulation of the various organic as well as inorganic compounds as well as water in order to maintain the pH of the body. क्योंकि फ्लूइड पार्ट जो है वो ब्लड ही है जो फ्लो करता है. अगर पीएच फॉर एग्जांपल केमिस्ट्री लैब में जब हम वर्क करते हैं और अभी हमें किसी का पीएच एडजस्ट करना होता है तो आप क्या करते हो? अगर आपको एसिडिक बनाना होता है तो आप थोड़ा सा एसिड डाल सकते हो. बेसिक बनाना है तो आप सोचते हो कि इसमें कुछ ऐसी चीजें हम डालें जो अल्कली हो और जिससे इसका जो पीएच हो वो बेसिक की तरफ शिफ्ट हो जाए. तो वो सारा काम हमारे बॉडी में कौन करता है? ब्लड करता है. इट हेल्प्स टू मेंटेन द पीएच ऑफ द body. The other one is your distribution of heat. Basically, blood maintain the body temperature to a constant level. Hamara body ka temperature jo hota hai, wo constant hota hai, 37. And that is usually being maintained by the blood because the heat produced during the various biochemical reaction is distributed throughout the body equally. Distribute kaun karta hai? Blood. Aisa to nahi hai na ki hamare kabhi body ka हैंड का जो टेम्परेचर है वो कुछ और होता है, लेग का कुछ और होता है, फेस का कुछ और होता है. नो, इट्स द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ हीट, इक्वल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. दैट मीन्स द टेम्परेचर रेगुलेशन. Blood maintain the body temperature to a constant level after distributing heat within the body. So distribution of heat is related to maintaining constant temperature. Now it's clear, Zunaid?
Yes, ma'am.
Maintaining constant temperature. Okay. Let me click the pic and we will proceed. Basically, when we will learn about the lymphatic system, how it works in our body, there are two different type of lymphoid organs, primary lymphoid organs and the secondary lymphoid organs. Primary lymphoid organ, as I have discussed with you when we are talking about the B lymphocytes and the T lymphocytes. That is your bone marrow and thymus. They are the primary lymphoid organs where these leukocytes are being formed and get matured. But from there, they migrate to the different lymphoid organs where the lymph is also being secreted. They are your tonsils, they are your spleen, they are your lymph nodes, pear patches in the small intestine, ileum of the small intestine, Kupffer cells in the liver. ये नाम बहुत important है, तो वो मैं लिखूंगी और आपको note कर लेना है ताकि आपको पता हो इन सारे जगहों पे हमारा जो है lymphatic system present है. And lymphatic system is basically to help to fight against the infection. हमारे immune response को strong करने के लिए हमारे body में along with the blood circulatory system there is lymphatic circulatory system. The major role of the lymphatic system is to provide a bigger strength in order to fight against the infection. ये एक extra power, extra supporting system है हमारे body के अंदर. So we are talking about the lymph. So the other point that we have to learn is lymphoid organs. So ये सारे organs जो lymph secrete करते हैं, they are known as the lymphoid organs. They secrete the organ which secrete lymph are called lymphoid organs.
Ma'am, it's not visible.
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. So, lymphoid organs, the organs which secretes lymph, are your lymphoid organs. There are many lymphoid organs. When I talk about the primary lymphoid organ, I will say bone marrow and thymus. Bone marrow and thymus. There are many secondary lymphoid organs, various lymph nodes, tonsils, spleen, which is the largest lymphoid organ, largest lymphoid organ. So pear patches, it is present in small intestine, the lower part of the small intestine, that is your ileum. मुझे लगता है अभी आपने digestion पढ़ा है, वहाँ जरूर पढ़ा होगा. Who else remember pears patches? Harshvardhan, are you there?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, pear patches पढ़ा था आपने, small intestine.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, So that is also your lymphoid organ, which is present in the ileum of the small intestine. Along with the Peyer patches, the next one is your Kupffer cells, which is present in liver. Peyer patches kidhar hota hai? Small intestine, important, wrote it down. Kupffer cells kidhar hota hai? It's in the liver. And these all cells, Kupffer cells of the liver, are phagocytic in nature. They engulf the foreign particles and help to fight against the infection. So the major role of these lymphoid organs to help the body in order to get rid of any type of infection. Note it down. So circulatory pathways, we all are aware that humne bachpan se ma'am, what is Peyer's patches? So bachcha, basically these Peyer's patches, they are present in the ileum of your small intestine, and it's also the lymphoid organ. That means it will also contains the lymph and the lymph plasma and the lymph corpuscles. And what they will do? They will help us in order to get rid of the infection. Ye lymphoid nodules hai, which is an important point of your immune system. हमने बहुत सारे ऐसे diseases पढ़े हैं जहां पर जो disease है उसका root of entry होता है through the contaminated food and water. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So they enter our stomach, our small intestine. So our body, they have a different type of lymphoid cells. This is the lymphoid tissue that is present in the small intestine, and they are being performing the role of the immune response. They help us to get rid of the infection, eat the pathogens. Usko destroy karne mein help karte ho, isliye ye small intestine mein present hai. So Peyer patches is nothing but it's a tissue. It's a lymphoid tissue. Okay? Lymphatic tissue that is spread throughout the ileum region of the small intestine. Clear? Aur ye prevent karta hai growth of bacterial population in the small intestine. Clear now to each and every one of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, the growth of the bacterial population. Usko रोकने में हेल्प करता है बिकॉज इट्स प्रोवाइडिंग अस द इम्यूनिटी. ये हमारे इम्यून सिस्टम को स्ट्रॉन्ग करने के लिए मैंने बोला ना, थ्रू आउट द बॉडी एट द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स द डिफरेंट लिम्फोइड ऑर्गन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन ऑर्डर टू गेट रिड ऑफ द इन्फेक्शन. तो वन इज योर Peyer patches दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन द ileum ऑफ द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. दिस इज नथिंग बट इट्स ऑल्सो लिम्फोइड टिश्यू, इट्स ऑल्सो लिम्फोइड ऑर्गन. नाउ वी विल टॉक अबाउट सर्कुलेटरी सिस्टम.
Can question on lymphoid organs come?
Yes, bachcha.
Ma'am, in the exam, can they ask us questions on lymphoid organs?
Yes, definitely. Ki what are the which lymphatic tissue is present in the small intestine? Ye sare options honge. To Kupffer cells to liver mein hota hai. You have to go for the Peyer patches. Ye fir se aayega. जब भी मैं आपको डाइजेशन में आपने एक बार पढ़ लिया, अभी आप लिम्फ पढ़ रहे हो वहां पढ़ लिया, फिर जब हम ह्यूमन हेल्थ एंड डिजीज पढ़ेंगे वहां पर भी ये डिस्कशन होगा. ओके, सो सर्कुलेटरी पाथवेज. सर्कुलेटरी पाथवे इज ऑफ टू टाइप्स, ओपन एंड क्लोज्ड. ओपन सर्कुलेटरी पाथवे. In open circulatory pathway, there is no closed blood vessels. For example, in our body, the blood is being flowing in the blood vessels. That is closed, separated, arteries, veins, and capillaries. But in case of the open circulatory system, there is no closed blood vessels. That means the blood is pumped by the heart. What happens? Blood pumped by the heart, into open spaces, broad open spaces, jisko hum sinus bhi bolte hain, sinuses. यहाँ पर वो रिलीज करता है. दिस ओपेक स्पेसिस इज नोन एज हेमोकॉइड. एंड इन दिस ओपेक स्पेसिस देयर आर हेमोलिम्फ प्रेजेंट दैट इज सिमिलर टू द ब्लड. द ऑर्गन्स विच नीड टू एक्सचेंज द सब्सटेंसेस विथ द hemolymph, they get in touch with the hemolymph and exchange the substances in order to get circulated throughout the body. So yahan par jo heart hai wo blood ko pump karta hai into open spaces. You can see here that is your hemocoil, and this hemocoil consists of hemolymph which is similar to the blood ke jaise hi hai. ठीक है, सर्कुलेटिंग फ्लूइड है. योर हेमोलिम्फ इज द सर्कुलेटिंग फ्लूइड. इन दिस सिस्टम सेल्स डायरेक्टली कम इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद हेमोलिम्फ. द सेल्स सराउंडिंग सेल्स डायरेक्टली कम इन कॉन्टेक्ट विद द हेमोलिम्फ एंड द एक्सचेंज ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस, वेदर द न्यूट्रिएंट, वेदर द गैसेस, वेदर द एक्सक्रीटरी प्रोडक्ट आर एक्सचेंज्ड बिटवीन देम डायरेक्टली. एंड इट्स एन ओपन सिस्टम. There is no closed blood vascular system. There is no closed blood vessels. And your, what is your hemolymph? It's the circulating fluid.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, after open spaces, what you have written?
Open spaces. These open spaces are also known as sinuses. इरेग्युलर स्पेस, ये बड़े बड़े स्पेस होते हैं, ओपन स्पेस होते हैं, जिसको हम साइनसेस भी बोलते हैं या फिर बॉडी कैविटीज बोलते हैं. यू कैन से ओपन स्पेस साइनसेस, एस आई एन यू एस ई एस, साइनसेस, और दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज बॉडी कैविटीज. So this is your open circulatory system, which is basically being found. Where they are found? In lower organisms. Ye basically hume lower organisms mein dekhne ke liye milta hai. Example, arthropods and mollusks. Example, hamesha yaad rakhna, aata hai question. Important. So the example of the open circulatory system is your arthropods and mollusks. Now your second is your closed circulatory system, which is found in higher organisms, in vertebrates. We find the closed circulatory system. So what happen in case of closed circulatory system? In the closed circulatory system, blood flow in the closed blood vessels, closed tubes mein flow karta hai. Is tarah se open space mein circulatory fluid present nahi hota hai. So in the closed circulatory system, blood flow in blood vessels. Blood flow in closed blood vessels. In case of open circulatory system, there is no blood vessels. The blood or the circulating fluid is present in a small or a larger, not small, bade bade body cavities hote, sinuses hote, jahan par wo present hota hai. It's not circulated. So blood flow in closed blood vessels, that is your closed circulatory system. Yahan par the cells are not in direct contact with the circulating fluid. Here the cells are in direct contact. Agar is cell ko exchange karna hai substances, it will come in direct contact with the circulating fluid. But the other, another difference between open and closed circulatory system, in closed circulatory system, cells do not come in direct contact with the flowing blood in the blood vessels. It will release the substances, and the capillaries are the connection between the cells and the blood vessels. So basically, in case of closed circulatory system, yahan par ek aur difference hai ki cells do not remain in direct contact with the blood. cells are not in direct contact. Cells are not in direct contact. Cells are not present in the direct contact, and out of these two circulatory systems, the closed circulatory system is more efficient and is usually found in the chordates. Chordates ki baat karte hain, vertebrates ki baat karte hain, as well as in the annelids. Annelids mein milta hai aur vertebrates mein milta hai. So this is all about the closed circulatory system. Example hai iska annelids and chordates. Example you should remember. Annelids and your chordates. Now we have to learn ki what are the different types. Jo study of heart hota hai, that is your cardiology. But heart is divided into circulating system. हमारे डिफरेंट जो है हमारे डिफरेंट कम्युनिकेटिंग चेंबर्स में डिवाइडेड है. फिशेस वी नो दैट दे आर टू चेंबर, बट जब हम एम्फीबियंस की बात करते हैं तो वी टेल दैट द एम्फीबियंस दे आर थ्री चेंबर. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द ह्यूमन एंड द मैमल्स वी से दैट दे आर द फोर चेंबर. तो हाउ दिस डिफरेंशिएशन इज बीइंग कैरीड आउट, उसमें कितने ऑरिकल्स होते हैं, कितने वेंट्रिकल्स होते हैं, दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव टू लर्न. तो हार्ट विच इज बेसिकली अ थिक मस्कुलर टिश्यू जो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट और रिलैक्स करता है, दैट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू इंटर कॉम्युनिकेटिंग चेंबर्स एंड दैट इज योर एट्रिया एंड वेंट्रिकल्स. ओके, सो लेट मी रब दिस एंड वी विल प्रोसीड फर्दर. When we talk about the open circulatory pathway, in that case, there is no blood in the circulatory pathway. Blood nahi hota. Instead of that, they have large cavities, body cavities, in which fluid is present, circulating fluid is present. That is same as your blood. But वहाँ पर क्या है वो? हम उसको क्या बोलते हैं? हम इस place को, body cavity को hemocoel बोलते हैं. And in this circulating fluid is present, which is similar to the blood, similar not in composition. Just आपको difference समझाने के लिए कि closed circulatory system में blood flow करता है, but in case of open circulatory system, हमारा circulating fluid जो है वो lymph है, but वो flow नहीं कर रहा है, वो different body cavities में present है. The cells can come in direct contact with the hemolymph and undergo the function of exchanging the substances. For example, सबसे simple example बताती हूँ. जब भी हम animals में division पढ़ते, animal kingdom पढ़ते, तो सबसे पहले हम sponges के बारे में पढ़ते. तो what happen in case of sponges? Their outer layer, that is the skin, help in the exchange of the substances between the outer environment and the inner environment. Yes or no? आउटर एनवायरनमेंट से वॉटर करंट के थ्रू जो वॉटर है वो एंटर कर रहा है, उसके अंदर बहुत सारे सब्सटेंसेस है, द न्यूट्रिएंट्स दैट दे नीड फॉर द सर्वाइवल. तो जैसे ही वो एंटर करता है थ्रू द बॉडी सर्फेस, देयर इज एक्सचेंज ऑफ द सब्सटेंसेस एंड दे आर एक्सक्रीटेड आउट ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द सेम वे, बॉडी सर्फेस से ही वो बाहर चला जाता है. So this open circulatory system is found only in lower organisms, lower animals. When we talk about the closed circulatory system, we are talking about the higher animals. Is it clear, bachcha? Ab samajh mein aaya?
Yes, ma'am.
So ma'am, now we are talking about the heart. Your heart is a thick muscular organ. It's a thick, hollow muscular organ, which is basically made up of cardiac muscular tissues. टिश्यू से बना हुआ है, मसल से बना हुआ है. सो योर हार्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू, योर हार्ट इज थिक.
मैम अपर साइड इज नॉट विजिबल.
थिक हॉलो मस्कुलर टिश्यू. Your heart is a thick, hollow, muscular tissue made up of, mainly they are made up of cardiac tissues. कार्डियक टिश्यू से बना हुआ है, कंपोज्ड ऑफ कार्डियक मसल फाइबर्स. योर हार्ट, आवर हार्ट इज डिवाइडेड इनटू intercommunicating chambers. Your heart is divided into, intercommunicating chambers. Heart is divided into intercommunicating chambers, and that is your auricles and ventricles. So in different organisms हम पढ़ेंगे कि क्या होता है उनके पास एक ऑरिकल होता है एक वेंट्रिकल होता है व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन सो वी विल इंक्लूड द ग्रुप नंबर ऑफ चेंबर्स इन द हार्ट इससे क्वेश्चंस आते हैं नंबर ऑफ चेंबर्स in the heart and auricles and ventricles number of chamber in the heart or name of chambers in the heart First, we will talk about the group of animal. में सबसे पहले हम बात करेंगे fish के बारे में fishes. We will talk about the fish. So number of chambers in the heart कितने होते हैं fish के? How many chambers?
Two chambers.
Here they have two chambers. And name of the chamber is the heart is one auricle and one ventricle. They have one auricle plus one ventricle. This is your fish. Fishes ke baad hum jayenge. The next one is your amphibians. How many number of chambers in amphibians? How many chambers are there in
three amphibians? Chambers?
Yes, they have three chambers. Abhi jab hi three chambers ki baat hogi, that means they have two auricles and only one ventricle. Isko thoda lamba kar deti hu. One auricle, iska iske saath hi likh deti hu. One ventricle. Here. Two auricles and one ventricles. When we are talking about the three chambers, then there are two auricles and one ventricles. Okay, now after fishes and amphibians, the third one is your reptiles. Reptiles may three or incomplete four. जब हम रेप्टाइल्स की बात करते हैं दे हैव थ्री और इनकम्प्लीट फोर दैट मीन्स दे हैव टू ऑरिकल्स बट द टू वेंट्रिकल्स आर नॉट कंप्लीटली डिवाइडेड दैट मीन्स टू ऑरिकल्स प्लस टू incompletely divided ventricles two auricles plus two incompletely divided ventricles now after your reptiles the fourth one is your apes एप्स के बारे में अगर हम बात करें तो दे हैव फोर टू ऑरिकल्स एंड टू वेंट्रिकल्स एंड द लास्ट वन इज योर ह्यूमन एंड मैमल्स दे आल्सो हैव फोर ह्यूमंस एंड मैमल्स
मैम कैन यू रिपीट आफ्टर एप्स
Yes, apes ke niche hai. The fifth one is your humans and mammals. Both have four chambers. That is two auricles and two completely separated ventricles. Main bhi diagram banaungi. Two ventricles. Auricles, has two ventricles. So, in case of fishes, as you can see, you can write it down and listen to me. Meanwhile, listen to me very carefully. In case of fishes, the deoxygenated blood is circulated by the heart. In case of fishes, the heart pumps out deoxygenated blood, which is oxygenated by the gills. Oxygenated kisne kiya? Gills ne kiya. And then they circulate throughout their body. And again, the deoxygenated blood enters the heart. Kyunki uske paas kya hai? Sirf ek auricle aur ek ventricle hai. I will draw the diagram also. Theek hai?
Ma'am, the board is blood.
What is blood? Everyone? No. Yeah, sure. So we are talking about the fishes. Fishes ke baare mein humne baat ki. The heart pumps the deoxygenated blood, which is oxygenated by the gills. Gills helps in the oxygenation and sent to the body parts. Aur fir wahan par kya ho raha hai? Body parts ne use kar liya, to again the blood becomes the deoxygenated, where deoxygenated blood is carried to the heart. So this happens in case of fishes. ठीक है? Fish में ऐसा हो रहा है और इस तरह के circulation को हम single circulation बोलते हैं. You know that in our body we have two circulation, double circulation. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. But in fishes, जो हमने ये पढ़ा कि fish में क्या हो रहा है, heart जो है वो पंप कर रहा है डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड. दिस डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड इन द गिल्स, गिल्स इसको कन्वर्ट कर रहा है ऑक्सीजनेटेड एंड ट्रांसपोर्टेड टू द वेरियस बॉडी पार्ट्स. और फिर वेरियस बॉडी पार्ट से डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड अगेन एंटर करता है हार्ट को. डीऑक्सीजनेटेड अगेन एंटर्स द हार्ट एंड दिस टाइप ऑफ सर्कुलेशन इज नोन एज सिंगल सर्कुलेशन व्हिच इज फाउंड इन फिशेस.
मैम रिकॉर्डिंग.
ओ सॉरी, रिकॉर्डिंग इज ऑन ना, चल रहा है रिकॉर्डिंग. Okay, and this circulation is your single circulation. ठीक है? Now, this is your single circulation. In fishes, in lung fishes, amphibians, and your reptiles. Lung fishes. Fish में भी एक exception है, lung fish. Amphibians and reptiles, देखिए उनके पास क्या है, three और incomplete four. That means two auricles and one ventricle. तो what happened in them? यहाँ पर क्या है, भी auricles दो हैं, right and left. Auricles एक different color use करती हूँ in order to make you understand. यहाँ पर दो auricle है, one is your right auricle and the other one is your left auricle. The deoxygenated blood enters the right auricle, deoxygenated. और जो oxygenated है वो enter करेंगे left auricle को. That is similar to that being found in the humans, जो हम हमेशा human circulatory system में पढ़ते आए हैं कि Zunaid, the auricle and atrium the same. बच्चा कल के class में हम ये discuss करेंगे. Auricle is a word that is used for the atrium क्योंकि वो जो है उसके surface area को increase करता है, because they have a dog ear like structure that I will explain you in the next class. There is a certain difference, but हम atrium के लिए ही auricle word use करते हैं. So listen here, जो हमने auricles के बारे में human circulatory system में पढ़ा है कि left auricle में हमारा oxygenated blood enter करता है और राइट ऑरिकल में हमारा डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड एंटर करते हैं, तो यहाँ पर भी यही है. द लेफ्ट एट्रियम गेट ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम, कहाँ से आएगा, गिल्स से आ सकता है, बॉडी सरफेस से आ सकता है, लंग्स से आ सकता है, फ्रॉम द वेरियट पार्ट, क्योंकि यहाँ पर आपका एंटर करेगा ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड दैट कम्स फ्रॉम द गिल्स, फ्रॉम द लंग्स, एंड राइट एट्रियम रिसीव्स द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड. तो ऑरिकल तो दो है, तो ऑक्सीजनेटर और डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड जो है वो सेपरेट है, बट वेंट्रिकल इज वन. वेंट्रिकल में जब वो फ्लो करेगा फ्रॉम एट्रियम टू वेंट्रिकल दे गेट मिक्स्ड, तो ये क्या है, ये इनकम्प्लीट डबल सर्कुलेशन है. सो इनकम्प्लीट डबल सर्कुलेशन इज फाउंड इन एम्फीबियंस एंड रेप्टाइल्स, क्लियर, बिकॉज हियर द एट्रियम दे हैव अ सेपरेट मोड ऑफ द एंट्री ऑफ द ऑक्सीजनेटेड एंड द डी ऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड फ्रॉम द वेरियस पार्ट्स, लंग्स, योर pharyngeal tissues, या फिर gills, या फिर skin, but in the ventricles they got mixed. तो ये हो गया तुम्हारा incomplete circulation, incomplete double circulation. When we talk about two auricles and two incompletely divided ventricles, that means जो दो auricles ऊपर में है, जो दो auricles ऊपर में है और नीचे जो ventricles है, जो दो part में divide होना चाहिए, there is a septum. To divide it into two ventricles. ये septum जो है ये incomplete है. Septum is a wall. हमें अगर घर में partitions करना होता है, जो हम wooden wall लगाते हैं या फिर जब भी construction चलता है, builders construct करते हैं, तो in order to participate the various portions, वो wall देते हैं कि ये bedroom हो गया, ये hall हो गया, ये kitchen हो गया. वैसे ही आपके ventricle में there is a septum जो कि complete नहीं है. अगर ये septum complete होता है तो it divides the ventricle into two parts, but this septum is not completed in case when we talk about two incomplete divided ventricles. तो ये septum जो है ये complete नहीं है, and this is being found in two auricles and two incomplete divided ventricles. But when we talk about the two auricles and the two ventricles, then this septum is कंप्लीट. ये septum पूरा ऐसे कंप्लीट हो जाता है. तो दिस इज योर राइट वेंट्रिकल एंड दिस इज योर लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल. दिस इज योर लेफ्ट वेंट्रिकल व्हेन द septum इज कंप्लीट. आई विल शेयर अ डायग्राम विद ऑल ऑफ यू इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड. व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट द फिशेस कि उनके पास सिर्फ एक ऑरिकल और एक वेंट्रिकल है, तो हाउ इट लुक्स लाइक. दिस इज योर auricle, one auricle, and this is your one ventricle. This is your complete two auricle and two ventricle. This is your two auricle, right auricle, left auricle, but incompletely divided ventricle. Incomplete ventricle. सबको समझ में आ गया? This is being found during the evolution of the heart. हमारा heart कैसे evolved हुआ है? किस तरह से they have intercommunicating four chambers. So it starts with the two chambers. After that, your incomplete three chambers. पहले ये बनाना था, फिर ये बनाना था. It's okay. This is your one. ठीक है? Incomplete. Four chambers, okay? And in apes, humans, and mammals, you have complete four-chambered heart, that is two auricles and two ventricles. When we have a two auricles and the two ventricles, there the oxygenated and the deoxygenated bloods are separated from each other, and that circulation is known as double circulation, which is found in mammals. Double circulation, which consists of a systemic circulation and the pulmonary circulation, that we will read itself in this chapter, so not to worry. So in humans and mammals, this is your single circulation. ये जो हमने पढ़ा था fishes में, this यहाँ लिखा है मैंने single circulation. In case of these two, जब भी हमने three की बात की और incomplete three की बात की, So this is your incomplete double circulation. Incomplete double circulation. But when we will talk about the four, we have complete double circulation. Clear to all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. ठीक है. जब ये एम्फीबियंस में हमने पढ़ा, हमने रेप्टाइल्स में पढ़ा इनकम्प्लीट फोर, तो वहां तो ये सेटअप सही है. बट जब हमने पढ़ा एम्फीबियंस में थ्री, तो ये कैसा दिखेगा? एम्फीबियंस में थ्री कैसा होना चाहिए? तो वेंट्रिकल पूरा तुम्हारा एक ही रहेगा, ठीक है, क्योंकि वेंट्रिकल इज वन एंड देयर आर टू ऑरिकल्स. देयर आर टू ऑरिकल्स, एक राइट और एक लेफ्ट. So this is in the case of amphibians. They have three chambers. So this is all about your heart, and the study of heart is known as cardiology. Or jo doctors isme specialized hote hain, they are known as cardiologist. Kisi ne chat question aayega single circulation, you will write about the example is fish. If the question comes incomplete double circulation, then you will write amphibians and reptiles. When the question comes complete double circulation, then we will write about the four chambered heart that is present in case of your reptiles, sorry, apes and humans. ठीक है, जहां पर ऑक्सीजनेटेड और डीऑक्सीजनेटेड ब्लड मिक्स नहीं होता है, एंड वी हैव two circulatory system, double circulation. And what are these double circulation? One is your pulmonary circulation and the other one is your systematic. We will read about this in detail, systematic. So we have this two circulation in case of humans also. अभी आगे अगर start करूंगी तो फिर थोड़ा सा ही कर पाए.